Thanks for tuning in to Know Wine in No Time. I'm your host, Dave, and today we're going to talk about the small indentation that's in most wine bottles. How did it get there, and what purpose does it serve? Well, this particular indentation is actually called a punt, but it's spelled P-U-N-T, like punt. And traditionally, wine bottles were made by hand, by an actual glass blower. And when they were about to terminate the bottom of the bottle, they would push the stem in and twist it. That would internally give it an indentation and also create a flat surface along the bottom for the bottle to sit very stably on a table. So that's how it got there. But today's bottles are made in molds. So why does the punt exist to today? Well, there's a lot of theories out there. And one of them is, of course, to pay homage to people who made wine for centuries. So that's certainly one. The second one is a deeper punt actually displaces a little bit of area inside the bottle, and it allows the winemaker to make their bottle look a little bit bigger than what it is. So for example, this bottle of Clareton Hill Syrah from Australia, the winemaker decided to actually have a very deep punt in the bottle, and that makes a 750 milliliter standard bottle look bigger, almost like a liter bottle. So there's a little bit of marketing technique that's done there, and of course you see it, deeper punts, wider bottles more in Pinot Noir and Chardonnay than you do in, let's say, a Bordeaux bottle. Also, when we look at sparkling wines, a deeper punt actually adds a little bit of structural integrity to a champagne bottle. It actually allows it to draw strength from itself. So that's another theory. So for non-sparkling wines, when you think about why that punt exists, a lot of us have been to restaurants, we've been served by a wine server, and a lot of times they'll actually take and stick their finger in the back of the bottle and actually pour it this way. This allows you to see the wine label very clearly, and it makes a very nice presentation into the glass. We couldn't do that if the wine bottle didn't have a very deep punt. And then there's one more technical reason why the punt exists to today. So let's say we're aging a bottle, and we've had a bottle sitting horizontally on the rack for a decade or multiple decades. Well, a special occasion has come up and we've decided to enjoy that bottle of wine. What you want to do is 24 hours before serving that bottle of wine, place it vertically. What that allows it to do is any sediment that's in the bottle will settle down along the bottom in the actual punt itself. Now, if we pour the wine very softly, that sediment will stay in the bottom in the punt. So, no one really technically knows why the punt exists today. It's obviously steeped in tradition, but there are numerous reasons why a winemaker would want to keep the punt in their bottles. So, that's all the time we have for today. Tune in next time, and soon you'll know wine in no time.